All right, how you guys doing? That's not loud. Y'all not listening. How you guys doing? All right, that's what I'm talking about. Did y'all like the spoken word artist? Yes. My name is Travis Corpening. I do a lot. I work for Cape Fear Community College. The presentation I'm using today is from my company, Shaper, which is a company where I get to do things like this, reach out to youth, reach out to adults working with youth, inspire people, right? Bring in artists like Life to do various things. Today, I want to talk to you guys about your future. Say future.
Future.
All right, today what we're going to talk about, I do a program, and I got one of my young moguls here. I do a program called Young Mogul. And Young Mogul really right now is a club of young men that get together to learn business principles and to kind of work on their own future. So today, what I want to do, I want to talk to you about yours. All right? Okay. Number one, I'm going to give you the mogul formula. What's a mogul? Somebody tell me what a mogul. Anybody ever heard that word before? Raise your hand if you ever heard that word. What's a mogul? You just heard it. I don't know. I just heard it. Nobody? Adults. Anybody ever heard of the word? Yes, sir.
If you're a mogul skier, or you're like an extreme, you're very good at what you do.
Very good at what you do.
Yeah.
On the next level, right? So usually when you hear the word mogul, it's referring to business, an entrepreneur, a CEO. They talk about, you see up here, I have the name Sean Puffy Combs. I had to break it down. I said he's got like four different names. For your generation, y'all know him as probably Puff Daddy, right? Nope. What do you call him? Puffy?
Diddy.
Oh, well, let me add that. He's got like 12 different names. Diddy is what we would call a mogul. A mogul dabbles in a lot of different areas, but all of them are successful in all of them, right? What I want to tell you guys today is that you all are the CEOs of your own life, your own destiny, your own future, right? A CEO, what's a CEO? I'm going to teach y'all some business terms today, huh? Say it again. Corporate executive officer, chief executive officer. You can flip-flop both ways. Chief executive officer, the one that runs things. I'd say I run things. All right? Now, vision, plan, execute. Those are my principles, right? I want each of you to think of yourself, and you know what? I'm going to skip to it. I want each of you to think of yourself as a brand. Now I want you to tell me what's a brand. What is a brand? Yes, sir.
A different type of
social,
like Gucci or something.
You say Gucci? Gucci is a brand. Give me some brands. Y'all know some brands. Y'all got brands on your feet right now. Give me some brands. Jordans, Nike, Ralph Lauren, KDs. What'd you say? Supra, was it the car Supra? Is that what you said? Versace, all of these are brands, right? All right, a brand is an image, a feeling, an emotion, what you or a product is known for. That's what a brand is. So what do I mean when I say you are a brand? Everybody in this room has a brand and is a brand. What I'm saying when I say that is, when you're not around, what people know you as, that's your brand. So even though I might be in your face saying, what's your name? Chris. What's going on, Chris? You know what? I like that edge up, Chris. You know what I'm saying? You looking fresh, bro. Right? Can't stand Chris, man. Can't stand Chris. Chris think he all that when he ain't around. Whatever other people say about you when you're not around, that is your brand. That is what your brand is. So what we're gonna do today is we're gonna learn how to shape our own brand. So first off, we talked about a few of them. Nike, what's the first thing that comes to mind when you think of Nike?
A check.
He said a check, I like that. What else, shoes, what else? Clothes.
Money.
Successful Michael Jordan. Why is it all of those things come to mind when you think of the word Nike? What have they done to make you think that? Commercials, shoes, advertisement. They spend millions of dollars, lots of money, lots of time to make you think what they want you to think, right? All right? McDonald's, same thing. Facebook, same thing. Twitter, same thing. McDonald's. I'm going to give you an example. Yes, sir. You think of fries and burgers, all the things that I'm trying not to eat. I was at the conference looking at the Chick-fil-A biscuits, trying to eat the fruit. Didn't happen. McDonald's. What comes to mind when you think of McDonald's? What else comes to mind? A clown. I'm going to stop right there for a second. He said a what? A clown comes to mind when I think of McDonald's. Why do you think a clown comes to mind when you think of McDonald's? Because of Ronald McDonald. I did the same thing with adults. They never say a clown. You got to plan your brand out to the teeth. And I know I'm speaking to young people, and y'all are like, well, I am totally changing anything that y'all have ever thought about yourselves. But if you, what you do at school, what you do after school, that is part of your brand. Who you hang with, that's part of your brand. You guys, how many guys use Facebook? All right? How many of you guys wouldn't have any problem with me going to your Facebook page? All right? I believe some of y'all are lying. So if I go to Facebook right now, what I'm about to tell you is, when you try to get a job, right now, what I do at Cape Fear, I work on people, I help people get jobs. Companies, go to your Facebook page. So if you post something right now, today, it's there. There's nothing you can do with it. There's a little thing right now called a screenshot. Y'all think I don't know. Who in here has taken a screenshot of your phone and saved it? Everybody, look around the room. So when you put something up there, raise your hand if you know what Snapchat is. Put your hands down. I like to do this. Adults, raise your hand if you know what Snapchat is. Let me have a kid tell me what Snapchat is. I need to pick a girl. There you go, in the back.
Snapchat is an app that you can take pictures, and whoever you're sending it to is the only person that sees it.
Yes, sir. You set it to how many seconds you want it to stay there, and then it goes away. What do you use Snapchat for? Wait. Say it again. What's your name? Kamik. Is that your name? Tell me what you said. He said what? Hey, you said it. Don't be scared. What'd you say? Bad pictures. None of y'all's mamas or daddies are in the room, so I'm gonna ask this question. How many of y'all sent bad pictures on Snapchat? Woo! You see, he did that teach me how to duck. He did that, woo! Put your hand back down. I was just playing, I was scratching. Y'all ain't fooling nobody. Y'all are not fooling anybody. Snapchat. Yes, sir. You think Snapchat's boring? Okay. Listen, if you post, say that again. He asked a question. What's your name? Mr. Mitchell asked a question. Why would you use it? Yes, John. Communication. That was a nice professional answer, John. I like that. Communication. All right. Yes, sir. Send pictures of your girlfriend? See, this is the problem right now. Time out. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Girls in the room. Girls in the room. All right, listen up. Females in the room. Did you hear what he just said? He didn't say take. He didn't say get pictures from your girlfriend. He said what? Say it again. Send. S-E-N-D. Send pictures of your girlfriend. So what does that tell you he's going to do if you give him something inappropriate? Huh? He is going to show everybody. I ain't mean to mess you up, but you put yourself out there.
He says he's not going to do it, he's lying.
You got to be so careful. You got to be so careful about your brand. These people I have up here, these names I have up here on the wall, do you think you'll ever see a picture of Barack Obama doing something, or Bill Gates doing something sent out on the web to his wife? Some, you're right. Barack Obama's phone is not even his phone. He got so many people checking his messages and sending and everything. You'll never see an inappropriate picture for Barack Obama. You got to take care of your brand just as much and just as hard, maybe harder than they do, because they have people looking out for them. You ain't got nobody looking out for you. Who has a cell phone? Everybody in the room. Everybody in the room got a cell phone. So everybody in the room has control of their own brand. You mentioned McDonald's at the beginning. We mentioned McDonald's, and I asked you, and when I said McDonald's, you guys said a clown. McDonald's, I'm gonna tell you why McDonald's actually is the one of the number one brands in the world. Number one brands in the world. You go to China, you go to any other country, they know McDonald's. Actually, by the age of 3, kids know the Golden Arches, recognize the Golden Arches by the age of 3. That is when you have mastered branding, right? McDonald's, tried something. How did the clown get started? We talking about Ronald McDonald, right? How did the clown get started? One day they decided they wanted to increase. Yes, sir. What you want to say?
I know they started the scare.
No, not exactly. Mm-hmm. McDonald's said, you know what? We want to increase our profit. We want to make more money. We want to increase our visibility, right? So what they did was they said, we'll try an experiment. We're going to invite a clown in. We're going to invite a clown in one day, right? One day a week. They invite the clown in. What happens on the days they invite the clown in?
Kids
come in. What else? Money increases. So when the clown comes in, they get smart. You know what? Every day we bring the clown in, money increases. So what are we going to do? We need to bring the clown in every day. You got your own business? You want to start one? I can help you. We need to bring the clown in every day. So the clown became part of their brand. How can you use that? Whatever you can do to match yourself up with great things, that will help your brand. That will extend your brand. That will extend who you are. So when you go out and try to, I know you guys are, it looks like, who's the youngest person I got in the room? 11? Anybody younger than 11? 11 years old. So he's probably looking to get a job in the next, 5, 6 years? When you go to get a job, any of those pictures that you put up on Facebook, Twitter, I tell you right now, I do basketball videos. I do basketball videos. Pull out your phone. Somebody pull out your phone. Pull out your phone. If you can get internet in here, pull out your phone. If you pull out your phone, go to Google. Go to Google. I want you to type in basketball tips. Basketball tips. Simple as that. Go to Google, type in basketball tips. Anybody got it? Anybody got it? All right, scroll down. The first video you see. The first video you see. Who is it? Who does it say? The first video you see. The first video on Google you'll see will be me. Yes. I posted a video. You see it? He's very first video. So if you're in China, if you are in China and you go to Google and you type in basketball tips, the first video you're going to see is going to be what? It's going to be me. Now ask me if I intended on that happening. No. Absolutely not. I didn't do any. Check me out. Listen. This is important. I didn't do anything for that to happen. All I did was about probably 6 or 7 years ago, I went out to MP Park. Raise your hand if you know where MP Park is. Right? Guys asked me, wanted to meet me at MP Park. Said, I want you to do some basketball videos. Right? Back then, I was broke. Real broke. Had no money. Right? So I said, okay, cool. I'll go to the court. How much you gonna pay me? Pay me about $125. I said, $125 to show people how long I had to stay out there? He said, about 3 hours. $125 for 3 hours? I'd do it. Who would make $125 for 3 hours? Right? Especially when you broke. So I went out there, he said, yeah, I pay $125. So I went out there, did a couple videos, said, yo, you know, stayed out there, did a video. He said, you did a great job, right? Pay me my money, I went home. Right? Couple months later, he was like, you know what, you did such a great job. Why don't you come on out and do some more videos, right? Well, yeah, another $125, right? So I go out to the court, shoot the video up, everything. Couple years later, I'm walking around Wilmington, this town, Wilmington, right? And I'm hearing people saying to me, you know what? I'll be at the Y. You know what? You just great videos on YouTube, right? I didn't do no videos for YouTube. The videos I did, yeah, that's me. The videos I did was for a company called Expert Village. I'm trying to teach you about branding and how once you put it out there, it's out there. You have no control over it. Expert Village, right? Did the videos for Expert Village. Somebody took them off Expert Village. Well, I'm around town. People are saying, yo, I'm seeing you on YouTube. I'm like, okay, cool. You see me on YouTube? Yeah, right. And I'm like, no, you ain't see me on YouTube. That was somebody else. Years go by. Another year goes by. I'm starting to hear more and more people tell me. I'm hearing a friend, somebody that actually plays basketball professionally, is saying, man, yo, I really liked your videos on YouTube. And I said, you know what? People keep telling me this. I need to actually go to YouTube and see what they're talking about. And guess who it was? It was me. Never posted a video to YouTube ever in my life. But now I have over probably 6 or 7 million views on YouTube. Guess how much money I'm making off these videos? Zero. Making no money. Somebody's making money. Because I remember one day I was like, man, somebody is making some money off these. I got other people using my videos. Other people using my videos on their website. They pay a company about, what, $29, $30 to buy my videos, right, for a 2-year subscription. That means in 2 years, they got to pay them again to load my videos. And I get paid nothing off of that. You got to know your brand, y'all. You got to be smart about it. You put it out there, you can put it out there, it could work negatively or it could work positively. In my case, it didn't help me at all. Help me when I'm doing presentations like these where I can tell you I'm on YouTube, I'm on Google. But you guys have to be careful about your brand. If you put stuff out there, you put naked pictures out there, all of this stuff is important. When you get out of school, when you get out of high school, when you go into college, colleges are looking at this stuff. If I'm going to college, if I'm a college administrator, I work at a college. If I'm a college administrator and you're trying to go to college, you give me your name on the application and I put that in on Facebook, on YouTube, on whatever, and you up there holding some guns with your homeboys, it felt good for the moment. How many of you ever held a gun before? Put your hand up, you held a gun before. Tell me what it makes you feel like when you hold a gun. Yes, sir.
Powerful.
I always get that from boys. What else? Give me another word. What does it make you feel like to hold a gun? In the back.
Feel like I intimidate people.
Feel like you intimidate people, right? In charge. Gangster. The man of the house. Boy, y'all, I couldn't have wrote it no better myself. That's exactly what you feel like when you hold a gun. Now, you notice, I didn't say pull the trigger. I said hold a gun. So that means I just put it in your hand. That is what it makes you feel like, right? So if when I see guys on Facebook, and I'm going to tell you, Wilmington has a gang task force, gang investigative unit, right? I'm going to tell you, I'm going to be honest with you. They go when they go look for gang members, they go right to your Facebook pages. They go to YouTube. I'm being real. I'm telling you what I know because I used to do this. I was a gang outreach worker for 2 years. They go to your Facebook pages. They have arrested people off of what they posted on. They know, and you telling them exactly where to come. They know exactly, there's no way you can lie about it because you have. You gotta be intentional about your brand, what your brand is. And you know what? You need to do an experiment. I'm gonna give you all you guys homework. When you leave this conference today, I want you to ask 5 people what they think your brand is. Explain to them what a brand is and ask 5 people what they think your brand is and see if it matches what you think. He said just holding a gun makes him feel, what's that word you use? What was that word you used? Gangster. Just holding a gun, right? I want you to ask somebody what your brand is. Tell me right now, if I ask you what your brand is, somebody tell me what it is. Raise your hand. Let me have somebody that feels like they have a grasp of this brand concept. What do you feel like your brand is? Yes. You think being a geek, you think that's your brand? Is that what you want your brand to be? You always on a computer, always stuff like that. Do you have a problem with that? Nope, has no problem with it. If your brand, if that's what you want your brand to be, and that's what other people say about you, nothing wrong with it. Nothing wrong with it. Yes, sir. You're an athlete. You're an athlete. What are you doing? What are you doing to make people know that you're an athlete? You play sports. What else do you do? Kai meet. You don't know, how old are you?
11.
11, he's 11 years old. Give Kamik a hand, y'all. Kamik, the reason I want to give him a hand, Kamik, I want you to understand something. You're 11 years old, right? I started playing basketball when I was 5 years old. 5 years old, right? All right, I played basketball in high school. My goal was to play basketball in the NBA. So my next move was my first goal. With anything, with a goal, with your brand, everything, you need to create goals. Say set goals. Say set goals.
Set goals.
So his goal is your goal to go professional? His goal is to play in the NBA. All right. I don't want to kill his dream. We have to build his dream. So, Kamik, your first thing to do, everything you do, has to be involved with building that brand, your basketball brand. That means, what's the thing? If you want to go to college, what do you got to do? Get a great education. Because if I'm a coach, you know what? I don't want somebody on my team that's going to bring my team GPA down. So if I'm a coach, I need somebody with great grades. So that's number one. That's one thing you got to do. Other thing you got to do is you got to practice. You got to work hard. People think somebody's going to give you something. You know how many times people tell me, you know, I want to be a professional basketball player? I ask you, how many hours a day you play ball? Mm-hmm. Well, you ain't driving, so I can kind of leave you alone. How many hours a day you play ball?
Like 2 hours at
the park. Two hours a day at the park? That's pretty good. I play 3 hours a day. 3 hours a day, no question. Homework was done, I was playing ball. I changed everything, drinking water, I was eating fruits. I was on any and everything. I know y'all like, you in high school, that discipline? Because that's how bad I wanted it. That is how bad I wanted it. If you decide what you want to do, when I said set goals, I said that for a reason. Set goals. Once you set a goal, don't set a goal and just let it be out there. If you got a goal, if you really want to do it, you got to put some work into it. I know DeAndre wants to be a poet, right? I know that's what he wants to do. He likes music. He likes to do all these different things. So when DeAndre asks me advice, I give him real advice. You need to find a mentor. Say, find a mentor.
Find a mentor.
I know DeAndre wants to get better. So what I do, I'm real with him. When you find a mentor, don't just find somebody that you think might, find somebody that's good at what you want to do. Why would I find, if I want to be Bill Gates, why would I find a mentor that plays basketball? If I want to be Puff Daddy or Diddy, if I want to be Diddy, why would I go find somebody that works at the library? Find somebody that does what you do, is the best at what you do, what you want to do, and you ask them a question. You ask them, can you help me? Will you be my mentor? Just give me tips. We got to change the way we do. You need to look out for your brand. All right. We're gonna analyze the brands up here, right? Who is this?
Jay-Z.
Say it again, who is this?
Jay-Z.
What's his brand? Give me some. Whoa, time out. That was my bad. I just threw that out there. Raise your hand if you could tell me what his brand is. Yes, sir. One word. He got everything. All right, give me somebody else. One word. What's part of his brand?
Business.
What's part of his brand?
Illuminati.
Hey, wait, time out. I'm glad she said that. Why? You know why? Because that's a part of his brand, whether he wanted it or not. That's a part of his brand. When people think Jay-Z, a lot of people think Illuminati. Yes, sir.
Money.
Music.
Driven.
He's a hard worker. Infinite. What does that mean? What do you mean by that? I know what it means, but what do you
mean?
And do it. Okay. All right. Beyonce, that's part of his brand. That's who is Beyonce to Jay-Z? His what? His wife. Glad you said that. You know why? Because the boyfriend or girlfriend you with is part of your brand. And you never thought about it like that, huh? Well, I love him. I can save him. I love him. I know he a thug, but you know, he's got potential. Y'all laughing, but it's the truth. Yes, ma'am. Blue Ivy, that's part of his brand. That's his daughter. When you guys are attaching yourself to other people, if you're attaching yourself to someone, if you have a brand, you set a goal. This is what my brand is. This is who I want to be, right? Everybody that you are around should match that. Everyone you are around should match that. So right now, you need to take out your phone, look on your Facebook page, and check all the people that you are friends with, your close friends. I'm not talking about the ones, you know, she just sent me, I don't know who it is, somebody in Australia, and I accepted the phone. No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about your close friends, the ones you speak to on Facebook. And you need to see if they match your brand, who you want to be. If it doesn't match your brand, guess what you need to do? He said unfriend, block. If you want to be serious about this thing, I know I might be hurting somebody's feelings. I might be breaking up some relationships tonight. Right? You have to be intentional about this. When you get time, when you're ready to go to college, right? My session is talking about resources. Resources, right? Guess who your biggest resource is going to be? Guess who your biggest resource, you guys are teens. Guess who your biggest resource is right now? Your parents. Your parents. I told you to find a mentor. Your mentors. Coming to conferences like this and connecting with somebody that's doing what you want to do. Give me some of your goals in the room. What do you want to do in the back? On the right.
Finish making my last poetry book.
Finish making your last poetry book. She came to the right conference. Guess what? We got poets in the room. Yes, sir.
Join the Navy and be master on this and then retire and become a cop.
Came to the right conference. We got it. Military, and we got a cop. The cop was the motivational speaker downstairs. Yes, sir. You want to do music? You want to do music. So you need to find somebody that does music. Do you have a mentor?
No, I mentor myself.
You mentor yourself. Mentoring yourself is great, but you only go so far. You need there's certain things you don't know. You need somebody to help you with that. All of us need mentors. I'm grown. I have a mentor. Good. Yes, sir. You want to be a famous what? Famous poet? Came to the right conference. Yes, sir. Professional football player. What is YMOD? What is that? YMOD, yeah. Young Men of Distinction. Okay, I like that. Somebody else in the yellow and blue shirt. Yellow and blue jacket. Electrical engineer, ooh, a lot of money. Whatever you want to be, you need guys. Your homework is to find somebody that is that and talk to them. Your biggest resource is your parents, right? Second thing, you need to contact your local college, your local community college. What's the local community college here? Cape Fear Community College. Why do I say that? No, not because I go there. Why do I say that? You get classes, but you guys aren't old enough to go to college yet. So why am I saying contact your community college? In the back.
Get stuff set up.
Talk to somebody. Yes, sir. See how they can help you. We have so many programs at my college. It's ridiculous. I do continuing education programs. Continuing education is for people who want to get a job, the list goes forever. Anybody that wants to get connected to something, they can get connected to it through my program. I have had people come to my office crying because they can't find a job. Literally crying because they can't find a job. I had those same people leave my office crying because they just got a job. Right? So you need to find your local community college and connect with it. Also, another resource you guys don't take advantage of, guess what? It's a secret too. Your school. Your guidance counselors. Who's actually had a conversation with that guidance counselor about what they want to do? If you want to do something, you got to talk to your guidance counselors. They have what? They have this magic word, starts with the letter S. Scholarships. They can give you information on scholarships. They can give you information on different colleges that you might be interested in. Right? Your brand. Give me my name. Who is this?
Oprah.
What's Oprah's brand?
Therapy.
Money. TV. He said therapy. What else?
TV show.
She's got her own TV show. She got her own network.
She helps others.
I'm glad he said that. Why do you say that, Sean? Give me an example.
If you think of her show and all the people she's had on there that she's helped, and plus she gives back to charity. She's just someone that she gives back. She understands where she came from, and she gives back to the people that need it so they can have a fair shake at life and be successful.
Yes, she does. Oprah has her own school. Yes, she has her own school. Where is this school? Anybody know about Oprah's school? Where is her school? Her school is in Africa. And her school is for girls. A lot of people, don't get mad. Her school is for girls. A lot of people, when she started her school, had a problem with Oprah. They said, you know what? Why don't you start a school here in America? Why you go all the way to Africa to start a school to help people? How many of you would agree with that? Raise your hand. Think she should have started a school here, right? You know what Oprah said when they started questioning her about that? First thing she said is, my money, I can do what I want to. That was the first thing she said. The second thing she said was, you know what, when I tried to start a school in America, I thought about starting a school in America and I would ask the kids what they wanted. Guess what they said they wanted? iPads, iPods. iPhones. Those are the things they wanted, right? When you ask the kids in Africa what they want, guess what they said?
Education.
An education. What does that say? Exactly. You got to want to be successful. The number one thing I had up here, I had it, and I can scroll down. I'll go to it later. But I'm probably going to miss it. Distractions. Distractions. Distractions are the biggest barrier for you guys making it to the next level. Distractions. Distractions are your phone, Facebook, Instagram, Vine. Those are your biggest distractions. You spend more time doing that than you spend doing anything else. I had a speaker that, there was a speaker that came to Wilmington. His name was Dr. Jawanza Kanjufu. I know you don't try to say his name. I had to practice it. The one thing he said that made so much sense, I want you to repeat after me. You do well what you do most.
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 That means if most of your time is spent on what? Facebook, Twitter, getting on people's nerves. I just wanna make her mad, see what she gonna do. All of that stuff, you are wasting your time. You're wasting your brand. Some of you had the greatest skills that, I mean, anybody could ever imagine, but you are wasting your time doing things that have nothing to do with that. John is a great poet. He's all shy. John is a great poet. You're a great poet too. I haven't heard any of your poems yet, but I know you're a great poet just because I know who you are. John is a great poet. He's shy. He's covering his head up right now because I said that. John is a great poet. But John, if John spends, I'm not going to put your business out there, John, but if John spends a lot of time doing things that have nothing to do with poetry, he's wasting his gift. If LeBron James is the best player in basketball right now. I did that on purpose. If LeBron James, listen. If LeBron James, the girl in the back, she was like, psh. If LeBron James, he's what, 6'8", 6'9", about 200 and what, 250 pounds, something like that. Ridiculous, huge, right? If LeBron James had all of that talent, all of that God-giving, all those God-given gifts, and he decided one day that he wanted to just go sell drugs. You laughing. It happens every day. It happens every day. I know people right here in this town, kids right here in this town, that are like some of the most gifted basketball players, God-given talents, not stuff you had anything to do with. I mean, you were born 6'9", and you walking around Wilmington and can play basketball, and you are wasting your time on the streets. I'm not telling you anything that I haven't seen. This is right now. Some of you guys are gonna be the next Bill Gates. Some of you guys are gonna be the next, who's Bill Gates? Some guy got a lot of money. That's right, baby. He owns Microsoft, one of the biggest names in computers, right? If Bill Gates had never taken the time to actually focus on his craft, his brand, we would never have some of the things that we have today. Internet, we might not have internet. We might not have a lot of things. So what I need you guys to do is, I need you guys to, when you leave this conference today, I need you to, one thing I need you to do is I need you to find out what your brand is and see if it's what you want it to be. If it does not match, then you need to do the things that, I've talked about today to make it match. All right? That's all my time. Anybody got any questions? Thank you guys very much. Pay attention to your presenters today.